All right, how you doing? This is Pete, Southwest Rod and Custom, Lewisville, Texas, suburb Dallas, Texas. Now, what we're doing today, we're back on our 1961 Chevy truck over here. Working on a lot of projects. We got the 34 Ford we've been working on. We got the 41 Willys. We got the 66 Chevelle. We got rid of our Vicky. We got rid of the other 34 Ford. You know, we got a couch we made. We got all kinds of shit going on. And right now I'm doing a collision repair job over there because, yes, I do collision jobs on the side, okay, to make ends meet. And that's the noise that you hear in the background. That's my paint booth going. But what we got here, okay, right here, all right, I'm gonna show that to you. I buy all my brake stuff from this company right here. Let me see if I can get that in there. There it is, Master Power Brakes, okay? And there's their address and blah, blah, blah. They're a real good company to work with. And the kit that we're putting on this, it's a universal under the floor kit, okay, for our brakes. I'm gonna go ahead and just scan the pictures your way. Okay, so watch real close here. Okay, there's photo one. Okay, give you a little idea. There's photo two. And there's photo three. Okay. Of course, that all comes with the booster and the master cylinder and the brake pedal and everything, but that's what's involved in that kit. I'll let you look at that there for a second if you wanna click on that and read it, okay? There you go. All right, so now we know what we got. So, what we start out with is we start out with our pedal assembly right here, okay? And if you look at that pedal assembly, it already comes mounted on its own bracket, which you can cut, okay, cut to fit. It also has pre-drilled holes if you want to go ahead and bolt that straight to the frame. But we're gonna end up cutting ours approximately right in this area right here. I already scribed a line on it. I don't know if you can see that. Okay, we're gonna cut that off. I've scribed a line on both ends. Let me flip it over here. There it is, okay. And we're gonna cut ours to put it on. Now, this is a universal pedal, okay, and it's got universal settings here. Let me see, there you go. Universal settings that will work to reset it to anywhere you wanna go, okay? So this is basically how the pedal's gonna look inside there, okay? And then we're gonna mount the bracket, something like that, all right? And then the pedal, of course, will be like this, and then it'll push the rod, see? Bam, bam, bam. Okay, so that's our pedal assembly. Then it comes with miscellaneous rods, okay? Now what these rods are for, this is a universal kit. So you don't have to have the brake booster this close to the pedal. See, we can have it, you know, this far away if we want. Let me get that in the picture there. See, we can have that this far away if we want to, or we can have it that close, okay? So it depends. And then it comes with a 7-inch booster, and I might say that's the shiniest high-tech booster I've ever got. That could actually be used as a show car quality piece. Too fucking bad it's going under the truck. And then we got the dual master cylinder, which is equivalent for a combination of disc brakes, drum disc brakes, drum. You see what I'm saying? So it all depends on what. This is a dual diaphragm, okay? This is a dual diaphragm booster, and this is a dual cylinder, okay? That's the best you can get. So this will be mounted up under the car. Then, of course, we got our little pedal that comes with, okay, and you'll have to weld a bolt onto it, okay? And then here's our adjuster rod that goes inside the booster on this end right here, okay, if you look right there, all right? Now, this is very important when you're installing brakes in your car. This is the most important thing that you can do of installing brakes on your custom car, your custom street rod, or your custom chop top, your rat rod, your hot rod, your lead sled, whatever the fuck you're building. This is the most important thing that I'm gonna show you right now. This is called a combination residual proportioning valve. And that's it right there. This will make your car stop just like a factory original car. This outbeats all other type of systems that you can use, which is the individual residual valves. You're gonna wanna put 5 pound in the front, 10 in the back. What that does, at least gives pressure, always has pressure on the brakes, so when you hit the brakes, they don't lock up on you. It always has medium pressure on it to bring you to a slow stop instead of a, you know, jerky stop. And this has a built-in proportioning valve, which is adjusted for the pressure of the brake booster. That's very important. Don't fucking put brakes on without this combination valve, okay? Of course, it comes with all the fittings, as you can see. Okay, that's a multi-fitting fitting kit and the bracket that bolts to the booster, and I'm gonna show you that when we get it all done. Now, this little kit right here, okay, is approximately $500, all right? For that little kit. Now, we also have a plate which is up under the car, and I'm gonna just show you the picture of it. If you look right here, it comes with this plate, okay? I don't wanna go down there and get under the car and do it. Now, we're gonna install this in our truck, okay? Because we have a nice clean firewall, and we're gonna have electronics on that firewall that are gonna interfere with the factory booster that we wanted to put on there. So, as I put this in, I am gonna film it the best possible way I can because I, my friend Pete, Last Chance Pete, Southwest Rod Custom, doesn't have a car lift, okay? We are old school and old fashioned over here. We use jack stands and jacks, floor jacks. So I'm gonna do the best I can and we'll see what we can do on that end. So, this is the system we're gonna use, okay? I've explained it the best way I can. I'm working over here doing this fucking job. I'm working over here, okay? And I'll be right back. I gotta go put a coat of paint on that fender. You stay right there. Go in the kitchen, get yourself a drink. I'll be back in a shake of a second. Fuck, right? Let's go check it out. Let's go see what we're painting in here. Yeah, let's walk in there. We'll look at that collision job. It's a 2000 Dodge truck, as you can see. And my paint booth has the Car McGee in it. And since this is just a little touch-up job, now there was where the dent was, right there. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead. I just painted that in here. See, that's a nice, quickie paint job. You know, repair. I love insurance jobs because insurance jobs, if you're gonna be a body man, do fucking insurance work, okay? So, back on there like that. Yeah, there you go, okay. So, there you go. So you see, I do odd jobs on the side. So you see, I do odd jobs on the side. Now to me, those are side jobs because these are my real jobs. So there you go. Like I said, I'm gonna try to do the best I can to show you how this is done. Even though I don't have a lift, okay, I'm sorry, I'm a poor boy here. And ain't got nothing but jack stands and jacks. Hope you fucking do. I still get the job done and get it done right. But there you go. We're gonna go ahead and install these on the truck. I'm gonna try to show you. This is Pete. I gotta get that other coat of paint on there. I'll see you later. Take it easy.